Hello.
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 And welcome to the Trouble with Bubbles.
Welcome to another episode of Astroneer with the Trouble with Bubbles. Now, since this is a Let's Play, I guess I could have been making the videos a little bit longer, so from here on out, the videos are going to be 30-40 minutes long, so we can get a little bit more done than we have in previous episodes. Alright, where we left off, I had just built my awesome all-terrain long-distance truck, and we were going to go out and collect some research and materials. Sorry if today's commentary is either a little bit funny sounding or sparse. I am still sick, but I wanted to get some stuff posted because it has been a few days. We'll get some of this resin and we'll be able to build our base up a little bit more. I think in the course of the next couple episodes, we're running out of stuff to do on this planet, so I'm gonna try to build enough resources and materials to leave this planet and go start life new somewhere else. I think that would be exciting. Plus, it'll be cool to see other planets and not just the same one. Ooh, look! Another spaceship in the distance. Let's go check it out. How are we doing on power? Right, so we're not doing great on power, but we should be able to find some. Hey, stop moving. And refill our truck on the way back. Or put that on there for now. Charge the battery with solar power while we're waiting, while the sun's going down. So I think I talked about this before, but I'm not 100% sure. These giant solar panels, they can be dragged back to your base using a winch, and then you can have a huge amount of power supplied by one solar panel. So if I had a winch, I could take it with me, but I don't. Oh no, the sun's going down. Well, let's head back anyway. We'll grab a small piece that we already know we have. And we'll head back to base and research this shiz. Assuming I can find my way back. Oh no! Why is my thing underground? Alright, that's better. In one of the earlier versions that I played of this game, I was playing two-player multiplayer, and whenever I would get out of the vehicle first, my friend who was in it would glitch out and send the vehicle flying. And so I spent a good hour, 2 hours looking for the missing vehicle, only to find it buried underground, and I had to dig it back out. It was the... I wish I'd been recording, because it was the funniest, most infuriating experience I've ever had with this game. Charge me. Charge me. There we go. Alright, let's try one that we may not have already done, although I'm sure we've already done most of these. Aluminum. It's okay, we'll take it. What are we still getting power? Oh, we must be getting power from those. I'm not sure what we're getting power from. But I won't complain. Charge. Why is this not working? This is... worked before. Don't drive in a hole. I forgot you can tether vehicles together. That would have been smart a while ago. Because now I can take this truck with me. Or the rover with. Right, so we're gonna need to build a shuttle. So we need 4 compound. There. Alright, let's go on a mission to collect items. So put that there. And we'll disconnect this for now because we don't really need the extra one. Grab this power from over here that doesn't want to work. Does it work in my backpack? Well, now I'm sucking from the... This doesn't make any sense. So there's power in my backpack, but for some reason it's stale or useless. Well, that's no fun. It's okay, the sun's coming up now. So we need to collect a large amount of compound and resin. Oh, I guess we can't, because if we build a shuttle... I need to find the blueprint for a spaceship, which is a much bigger thing that we can use to carry more items on. Well, we're starting to get solar power, so we can definitely run this research. Yay, more copper. I'm so excited. There's a new research. Come on, give me the spaceship. Fuel condenser. Well, I mean, it would come in handy. I'm not going to need it because I've got a nice big hydrazine mine right next to my base, but a fuel condenser lets you use convert energy into fuel. That's basically it. Alright, so we'll plug this in. Charge the battery. I'm not sure why this isn't charging. There we go. Alright, we'll hop in this bad boy. See if we can get out of here without running everything over. Alright. Can I get across this without dying? Nope. We'll just go this way instead. Oh no, more holes. There's a pile of resin. Learn to drive, idiot. I just called myself an idiot. Aha, this plant is yellow. Maybe it will give me a research that I've technically never found. Nope. Pretty sure I've found 100 of those. Let's head over to this compound mine. And grab some of that sweet, sweet compound and get away from our truck, because when you run out of power or you run low on power while you're tethered to your truck, you pull power out of it. So that's not good. Look at the size of this resin mountain. Why am I not getting any solar power? No, don't take the power from the truck. Oh no, the horizon's chasing me. Come on. Yeah. Get some oxygen. And go back up to this. We need a little more. We need a lot more compound than we do resin, so I'll call it good at that. Stop stealing power from the truck. Compound. I should dump this first. All right, let's grab this compound. Because we need... let's see. Give me some organic material. We'll use that to power up our generator. and get more of this sweet, sweet compound. Oh, we're out of room. It's too bad we didn't bring any storage. Wait, yes we did! So we need our compound for both the spaceship, the habitat we'll use on our new planet so we can survive and build another base. We'll also need compound because the planet might not have compound on it. It depends which planet we choose. Oh no, there's a hole there. More resin? No, we need some more compound. So we'll go around this way. Oh man, where's my truck going? Perfect landing. No, these are truly real accurate physics. What are you talking about? This could totally happen in real life on a random space planet. Trouble getting back to our home base. Maybe. If we do, there's plenty of little power fountains. Oh look, there we go. Right here, we'll stop. Park the truck in this hole. Grab some of this. Slap these bad boys on there. Oh sure, now they work. And grab a handful of this compound. Round out the inventory or dry up the mine, whichever comes first. Or run out of power. Because it's nighttime. It's always nighttime. It's so weird. I have not, in any of these episodes, and I've only been playing in these episodes, I have not encountered a single sandstorm on this planet. Which is uncharacteristic, because no matter what, there's always sandstorms on the first planet you land on. Whoa, what did you do that for? Thought I'd grab that because I have space for it. Alright, back to base to research our two items and then get ready to leave. Oh god! This planet for brighter or deadlier skies. Let's see. Research. Come on, big money, no whammy. Hydrazine, well, it'll come in handy now that we need a spaceship. There we go. Speak of the devil and it shall appear. One giant sandstorm. I should probably get inside something. Stop rolling your way, Chuck. Sandstorms are pretty fierce. If you have any items just laying on the ground, they'll blow away. If you're outside and one of the blocks hits you, it will kill you immediately. Yeah, one of those blocks. Sometimes it'll take your vehicles and push them away from your camp. It's altogether a sad and terrifying thing in this beautiful game. But it is a survival simulator, so what is survival if it's not dealing with nature and elements, environmental elements? This be a long one. Ow. There we go. And just like that, the sandstorm's gone. Come on, big money, no whammy, resin. Alright, so we need a habitat. We need a shuttle. Now, as silly as it seems, you can actually fly the shuttle from the habitat. But if you then place your habitat, if you don't have enough material on that planet to build another habitat, then you're stuck on that planet until you die. So, for the sake of materials, I think we will risk getting stuck on a new planet. Let's see how much hydrazine that is. Perfect. So let's fill up my inventory with all of these nice things. Aluminum and copper and more copper. Having two copper will be good. Having one aluminum might not actually be worth it. So we'll leave that bad boy here. We'll move this over here so we get one extra space in our inventory. And we'll put our resin storage container on our spacecraft. Fill our inventory with compound, whatever you want to call it. Whoops. Leave our generator behind. How do you make generators? Copper. Well, most likely we won't need a generator. Famous last words, huh? Alright, well now I think I've got sufficient copper and resin to mount my expedition away! It is kind of cheating the system to use your habitat as your means of transportation and means of only transportation. So let's see, we've got tundra, exotic, there's two more outside of our rotation, arid and radiated. Let's check out exotic, because I know exotic is pretty, and I believe that there are a lot of the materials that you need on exotic, so alright, let's pick this nice centered landing area and see what we've got. Oof. Oh, this looks dangerous. There's a bunch of copper ore. I don't like this landing spot. We'll find another one that's a lot less. Cliffy. So if we landed originally there, let's try this one. Well, that's equally cliffy. But, wow, whoa, look at all these new research types. Alright, well this will work because we can take our habitat wherever we like and actually plant it. Hey you, spiky douche. Yeah, go away. Seeds. That's new and I'm not sure how it works. Please don't die. Oh, good. I want to bury the seeds. Maybe they will grow. Although burying them would be, or having them grow would be bad. Alright, so since this is going to be our landing pad if we ever leave, we do want to build our base somewhat near it. And so it's either in this walkway through the trees right here, or... Ah, no. Ah, don't chase me. Or in this bigger, flatter area with all these weird little nubs. Or we just build it down here. Is this a tunnel into a cave? It is. Alright, well, we've got lots of choices. Let's see, can I grab you from down here? Alright, we're gonna put you right there. Alright. Time to start colonizing a new planet. Give me a resin. So we do need a printer and a research platform. So we'll start with the research platform. And we'll put our printer over here. This is going to be a small compact base. Hey. Hey. Go there. Perfect. Yeah, I know you don't have any power. Eventually the sun will come up. And yeah, we won't get a lot of power because we're in a valley thing, but that doesn't matter. Well, that about does it for this episode of Astroneer with the Trouble with Bubbles. This one's a little bit longer than the other ones, as you probably can tell. But they're going to start being a little bit longer because they are Let's Play. I'm not editing out bits and pieces. It's just full gameplay. So I hope you guys enjoyed and stay tuned for the next episode. Goodbye.